Whitney!
Yeah, Whitney!
Whitney! Whitney, do something! Alright. Hey.
Hey, everybody. How's it going?
It's going fantastic! Hello. A stander. Uh-oh. I know you guys, too.
Thanks for having us here at the Speak Out of Climate Change event. Climate change is an important issue that should be addressed more. I'm serious. It should be addressed more at a corporation and political level. And it takes our generation to make a difference.
Yeah. doing it.
Yeah.
Guys are doing great. Keep it up.
We're going to play one more here, too.
I'll play two more. Come on, man. Two more. What did he say? Oh, you only noticed.
Two more?
Okay. All right. Two more, baby. It's all social content for me, people. I'll stay here all night. Okay. Sorry, didn't mean to make your friend run off.
Thanks, Obama, for that. jokes. That's what I'm hoping to springboard off of this. You know, maybe do some Jay Leno. He's not still a thing anymore. Jimmy Fallon took over for that guy. I like Jimmy Fallon. But I was looking through my notes. I picked up a joke notebook, and I'm looking through for my climate change jokes, and there's a poop joke, sex joke, politics. Yeah, that one there is actually really expensive. I'm probably going to throw that one out. Another poop joke about my kids. Kids poop joke.
Okay. Yeah.
Let that one sink in for a second.
Yeah, that's a good one.
This guy gets it.
I get it.
I feel like I'm telling jokes to you.
That's
like
fine. Go ahead.
Here tonight,
that's
sir.
Fine.
This is what we're doing.
Does it work? Oh, my name's Tim.
Tim?
Yeah.
Tim, what do you do, Tim?
Well, I work with comedians.
I'm sorry?
I work with comedians.
You work with comedians?
Yeah.
So, you're used to this kind of
horrible
thing.
I know. And you just,
good.
So you just keep working it.
I'm glad to hear it.
You work with Mike, sir. Don't worry about me. And let's see, what's a good word to substitute for some of the words you normally use?
I don't know.
Oil spill.
For the words I normally use.
Oil spill. If it says oil spill.
I'm going to go a completely different direction.
Okay, you go. That's a challenge.
Climate change, though.
And he likes animals, too.
Yeah, you guys are fun. I try to do my part for the environment. I try to help out with climate change. I drive a Toyota Prius, which, as you guys probably know, a Prius is the number one vehicle on the market to prevent any woman from ever going out with me. So, there's that. We have that whole thing going on.
Not if I can help it.
We have several runners. We have some of you like, no, I'm not running.
Yeah, no.
And I understand, because personally, I do a lot of running, but I hate running. I hate it. It's awful. Like, your legs hurt, your lungs burn, you get a headache. And I don't know, maybe I'm not doing it right, but it just feels awful the whole time. And it's like, running to me is like a relationship. It makes you really miserable. It's a huge pain in your ass. It's awful. Running, another thing about running, all right, running shoes, they are the ugliest things now, you guys, you don't get groceries shopping.
No, they're college students.
I have those grocery bags, and those are really good in theory, right? The thing is, there's never been a time when I've been standing in that checkout line that I did not realize those bags were still in the trunk of my car. Mm-hmm. 6 years old, and I've never used those things one time. I cannot remember them. I can't do it. That's probably a joke for a different audience.
Yeah. Is this working material, bud?
Maybe a family. Yeah, it's about to work out the material.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for giving me a quiet place to practice my material here. But she's clapping. She's like, finally, he's done. No. Finally, he's going to get out of there. No. So I'm not quite done. I have a few more things.
Yeah, well, that's
I'm doing all right. Type of person. Hey, I'm figuratively green. I'm not literally a green person. There was one time I was literally green, but I had to get a penicillin shot for that. I'm going to pass on that for the future. I'm not a big fan of that too much.
Yeah, that's good.
I've been dating recently a lot, and I've been trying to find a lady who is equally environmentally conscious, who's trying to help out the environment, green, if you will. Now, I think I finally found one. She's a really good girl. She assured me that once she dies, she is fully biodegradable. So, I've got that going for me. By the way, any of you guys dating in here? Any of you guys on dating websites?
Not me.
Nobody. You guys are all happily in relationships. Congratulations. You guys have life figured out. Because, you know, sometimes me to things like, ah, that guy's a little bit of a jerk. Or, you know, that guy's not quite right for you. And those things, they're not very nice, but I can accept those things. You know, I can deal with those things. Not me. About me, she says that I am a demon sent straight from hell to tempt the soul of her innocent daughter. Well, joke's on you, lady. You get bring her ginger. She doesn't have a soul.
Oh.
I apologize to the young ginger in the room. I'm sure she doesn't have a soul. I like ginger, but then... When I was writing some jokes about climate change, global warming, I looked up some things and I discovered that there are several foods that are currently in danger of extinction because of climate change. There are several foods that we're not going to get to eat anymore if this climate change continues. And one of those foods is corn. There's no more corn. Grapes, coffee, chocolate. And I don't